Lesson 2. A. Karnataka. The administrative divisions of Karnataka. Our land is Karnataka. Our state has a history of 2000 years. Many parts of our state have prehistoric stone age sites. Historians have identified such sites in the various parts of the state. The magnificent history of our state is further studied in higher classes by you. In this chapter, we shall study about the four administrative divisions of our state and their significance. We shall also learn about the districts in each division, the natural resources, agriculture, industries, education, literature, arts, tourist places, and other aspects in detail. Various districts were formed during the British rule. In many instances, the district headquarters have got changed. Some districts were made smaller and some others have been extended. For instance, the Vijayapura district had Kaladagi as its district headquarters. Later, it was shifted to Vijayapura. Many new districts have been formed after the independence. Bigger states have been divided to create smaller ones. In order to facilitate better administration, Karnataka is divided into four revenue divisions. They are Bengaluru division, 9 districts, Mysuru division, 8 districts, Belagavi division, 7 districts, and Kalaburgi division, 6 districts. 30 districts in total. Each district is headed by a deputy commissioner and the division is headed by a divisional commissioner. We shall know about the districts, their uniqueness, natural resources, agriculture, industries, rivers, resources, crops, forests, climate, art, literature, folklore, sports, festivals, and fairs in brief. Bengaluru Division. Bengaluru is the capital of Karnataka. It is one of the administrative divisions of Karnataka. There are 9 districts in Bengaluru Division. They are Bengaluru Urban, Bengaluru Rural, Kolar, Chikkabalapura, Ramanagara, Tumkuru, Chitradurga, and Shivamogga. This division is in the southern part of Karnataka. History. Bengaluru has a history as rich as Karnataka. The earlier rulers were from the Ganga dynasty. Kualalapura was their capital, the present Kolar. After the decline of the Gangas, the area came under the rule of Cholas, Hoysalas, Vijayanagar kings, Marathas, Mysore kings, and Bijapur's Adil Shahi. During the rule of Vijayanagar Empire, Palegara or administrative chieftains were appointed to administer different regions. These regions were called Palepattu. Palegaras were the leaders or Nayaks and reported to the Vijayanagar kings. They had to submit tax and gifts to the king. Some of the important Palepattus were Keladi, Chitradurga, Yelahanka, and Chikkabalapura. Natural resources. Resources obtained from nature are called as natural resources. Rivers, forests, waterfalls, animals, soil, minerals, and other resources provided to us by nature. Bengaluru division has tropical monsoon climate. The climate of all the districts is not similar. Kolar has the hot climate, whereas Shivamogga region gets highest rainfall, but Chitradurga receives lowest rainfall. The remaining districts, Tumakuru, Davanagere, Ramanagara, and Chikkabalapura, receive moderate rainfall. Many of the rivers in this division originate in the Western Ghats. Some of the important rivers are Uttara Pinakini, Dakshina Pinakini, Vedavati, Shimsha, Tungabhadra, Sharavati, Varada, and others. River Sharavati flows in the western direction. World famous Jog Falls is in Shivamogga district. Waterfalls named Muthiyalamadu is in Bengaluru district. Gajanuru and Tunga dams are in Shivamogga. This division has numerous tanks. Mysore kings have constructed many dams. Vani Vilas Dam is one such irrigation project. This is in Hiriyur Taluk of Chitradurga. Another dam is at Marakonahalli of Tumakuru district. Many of our rivers have dried out due to environmental pollution, deforestation, uncontrolled urbanization, and many other reasons. Many rivers of Bengaluru urban district are on the verge of extinction. As a result, severe scarcity of water is there. There is an urgent need to protect the water sources like tanks and save underground water. This division has many mineral deposits. The most productive gold mines of the country are in Karnataka, and Kolar gold mine is famous among all. But the gold deposit of this mine is exhausted. Iron ore deposits are found in Chitradurga and Tumakuru districts. Chitradurga also has copper ore deposits. It is said that mineral necessary for atomic energy production is available in Chitradurga district. Forests, wild animals, and national parks. Shivamogga has the dense forest cover in Bengaluru division. The forest cover of Bengaluru urban district is the least. The districts of this division have forests ranging from evergreen forest to deciduous forest. The Sahyadri mountain range passes on the borders of Shivamogga district. These forests have bamboo, banyan, tamarind, sandalwood, dindiga, teak, jali, mango, and neem trees. Minor forest produce has been the means of livelihood for many people. The tallest mountain in this division is Halurameshwara Gudda in Chitradurga district. Other famous mountains are Kavale Durga, Chandragutti, Kodachadri, and Nandidurga. This division has many wild animals. Wild cat, tiger, leopard, bison, wild pig, deer, bear, and wolf are some of the important wild animals. For the protection of the forest and animals, many forest reserves, wildlife sanctuaries, and national parks have been set up. Some of these are Jogimatti Forest Reserve in Chitradurga, Bannerghatta National Park in Bengaluru, Bhadra Wildlife Sanctuary, Sharavati Wildlife Sanctuary, Shettihalli Wildlife Sanctuary, Gudavi Bird Sanctuary, and Mandagadde Bird Sanctuary in Shivamogga. Kaggaladu Bird Sanctuary in Tumakuru, Ramadevara Betta Vulture Sanctuary in Ramanagara, Jayamangali Black Buck Sanctuary in Tumakuru. Children, do you want to see wild animals like tiger, bear, elephant, deer, and other animals in the forest? If so, do visit the wildlife sanctuaries and bird sanctuaries present in your division and enjoy seeing those wild animals in their natural environment. Agriculture and growth of industries. Agriculture is the main occupation of people in Bengaluru division. This division has more dry land agriculture. The agricultural activity is rain dependent. Shivamogga district is well irrigated. This division has sand-mixed red soil. Black soil is also available in some parts. The main crops of this division are ragi, maize, paddy, groundnuts and various pulses, coconut, arcanut, cotton, sugarcane and others. Mulberry, which is the backbone of silk industry, is cultivated in Bengaluru and Ramanagar districts. Fruits like sapota, papaya, jackfruit, orange and banana are grown in this division. Ragi and rice are the major food staple food in this division. Rotis made of ragi and rice are consumed more. The usage of chapatis made out of wheat flour is more in recent times. Sweets like payasa, holige, khichdi, shavige are consumed during festivals. The government has established agricultural produce markets in all the taluk and district headquarters. Here, the farmers can sell their produces directly. The government has also established granaries or warehouses in all the district and taluk headquarters. The farmers can store their produce here. Sarem Vishweshwaraya is the founder of our state's industrial sector. He implemented the forethought of Krishnaraja Vadaiyar IV. If we do not establish industries now, we can't attain progress. Big industries have been established in places like Bengaluru, Bhadravati, Tumakuru, Shomogga and other places. Bengaluru is the most important industrial place in India. There is an iron and steel industry in Bhadravati of Shomogga district. It was established in the year 1923. It is now called as Vishweshwaraya Iron and Steel Industries Limited. There is a paper production factory here. It was established in 1936. The first cement factory of the state was established in Bhadravati. The Birla cement factory is in Amasandra of Tumakuru district. Bengaluru is known for information technology and biotechnology industries. Industries are the main source of employment. Karnataka is ranked second in the export of garments in India. The government has established apparel parks in cities like Doddaballapur, Anekal to promote the production of ready-made garments. Industries like aeronautics, electronics, information technology and biotechnology are active in Bengaluru. Some of these industries are public companies and many are private companies. Art, literature, folklore, theatre and dance. Three writers from Bengaluru division have received the prestigious Jnanapitha award given in the field of literature. They are National Poet Kwempu, Masti Venkatesh Iyengar and U.R. Anantamurthy. This is an indication of the literary achievements achieved by the Bengaluru division. This division is known for its art and literature since ancient times. Akka Mahadevi and Allama Prabhu, who contributed immensely to the 12th century Vachana literature, are from Baligavi of Shomogga district. Similarly, Sri Padarayaru, Purandara Dasaru and other who were part of Dasa Parampare are from this division. The modern literature has been enriched by the following writers of this division: Kwempu, D.V. Gundappa, Masti Venkatesh Iyengar, P. Lankesh, Nisar Ahmed, T.P. Kailasam, M.K. Indira, Tarasu, Dr. Anupama Niranjana, H.M. Nayak, M.V. Sitaramaya, B.G.L. Swami, K.V. Subbanna, U.R. Anantamurthy, Baraguru Ramachandrappa, Centenarian Venkat Subbaya, G.S. Shivarudrappa, Dalit poet Siddhalingaya, Dr. D.R. Nagaraja, Kotaganahalli Ramaya, K.B. Siddhaya, Doddarange Gowda, Pratibha Nandakumar and others. The achievement of this division in theatre field is equally notable like that in literature. The name of Gubbi Veeranna has remained eternal in the history of Karnataka theatre. The achievement of this division in theatre field is equally notable like that in literature. The name of Gubbi Veeranna has remained eternal in the history of Karnataka theatre. He had titles like Nataka Ratna, Nataka Sarvabhauma. The theatre company established by him, Gubbi Theatre Company, has completed 100 years. Another name of importance is that of Subbaiah Naidu in the history of Karnataka theatre. He was the hero of the first Kannada talkie movie, Sati Sulochana. The contributions of K. Hiranaya and his son, Master Hiranaya, known for their cultured comedy, are notable. Srimati Maya Rao, who contributed immensely in the field of dance, is from Bengaluru. She is a famous dancer and also opened a school of dance, Natya Saraswati, to teach and has trained numerous dancers. Now, Bengaluru is an important center of cinema industry. The film industry is growing positively due to the contributions from personalities like Dr. Rajkumar, actors like Dr. Vishnuvardhan, Shankar Nag, and others are worthy of memory. New wave films have also contributed immensely these days. This division is also known for folklore and folk art. The famous folklore expert and writer Dr. H.L. Nagegowda has established a folklore center, Janapada Loka, in Ramanagar district. It is a wonderful folklore museum. Many art crafts belonging to various folk arts, literature, theater are displayed here. The following are the famous folk arts of Bengaluru division. The Karaga festival that takes place every year in Bengaluru is a folk art. Somana Kunita, which is famous in South Karnataka, is another folk art. Mudala Palya Ekshagana is the famous folk theatre of this division. Garudi Kunita, Dollu Kunita, Kamsale Kunita, and others are the famous folk arts. The contributions of R.S. Naidu, Rumale Chennabasavaya, Venkatappa in the field of visual art are unique. Education and health. Bengaluru division has achieved immensely in the field of education. Two recipients of Bharat Ratna Award, the highest civilian honor of India, are from Kolar district of Bengaluru division. They are Sir M. Vishweshwaraya and Professor C.N.R. Rao. Sir C.V. Raman, the Nobel winning physicist, conducted his research in Bengaluru. Bengaluru is an important center of education. There are many famous public and private universities in this division. Apart from these, there are many central research and scientific laboratories too. Tumakuru, Bengaluru, Shivamogga and Davanagere have universities. There is an agricultural university in Bengaluru. The government is encouraging primary education since pre-independence period. Many religious institutions are providing education. Siddhaganga Math, a religious institution, is providing food and education to thousands of students under the leadership of Sri Shivakumara Swamiji. Another mutt Adi Chunchanagiri under the leadership of Sri Balagangadharanatha Swamiji is also providing education in the field of basic and professional education. The contribution of Murugarajendra Math and Sirigire Taralabalu Math of Chitradurga are notable. Most of the districts of this division have engineering colleges and medical colleges. Bengaluru division has achieved considerable progress in the field of health. It has contained contagious diseases. Infant death rates have been reduced drastically. Smallpox and polio have been eradicated completely. Monkey disease prevalent in the forest regions of Shivamogga has also been eradicated. In spite of all these efforts, children and women in rural areas are still malnourished. In rural areas, primary health centers and health sub-centers provide needed medical facilities. Every district center has a well-equipped district hospital. Bigger towns or villages have community health centers. Taluk centers have taluk hospitals. The government has established primary health centers which function 24/7 to ensure safe delivery. Mobile health facilities are there to provide better facilities to pregnant women. Cultural resources. Bengaluru division is very rich culturally. It is rich with forests, wild animals, rivers, valleys, religious places, tourist centers, cultural festivals and others. Political stalwarts have also contributed to the development of the state. The chief architect of Karnataka integration, Kengal Hanumantaya, is from this division. The Vidhana Saudha building was built during his tenure as the chief minister. Another pioneer of Karnataka integration movement, S. Nijalingappa, also undertook many important programs aimed at strong state. Shantaveri Gopala Gowda, who laid the solid foundation of socialist movement in Karnataka, is from Shivamogga district. Salumarada Timmakka is a synonym for environment protection. Anil Kumble has contributed immensely to cricket. B.K.S. Iyengar and Sri Raghavendra Swamiji from Malnadihalli, who have contributed notably in the field of yoga, are from this division. There are many scenic places in this division. Freedom fighters. Many prudent people from the Bengaluru division had taken part in the national freedom struggle. K.C. Reddy, the first chief minister of Mysuru state, the second chief minister Kengal Hanumantaya, another chief minister S. Nijalingappa, socialist leader Shantaveri Gopala Gowda, Kadidal Manjappa, Sharma, Bhagirathamma and many others had participated in the freedom struggle. Kengal Hanumantaya and S. Nijalingappa were also the architects of Karnataka integration movement. You will come to know more about these in the next chapters. Uniqueness of this division. Bengaluru division has 9 districts as mentioned earlier. Each district has its own significance. Ramanagara, Chikkaballapura and Davangiri districts of this division are newly formed districts. Bengaluru Urban District. Bengaluru is the capital city of Karnataka. Vidhana Saudha, the administrative center of Karnataka state government, is in Bengaluru. The High Court of the state is also here. Lal Bhag and Kabban Park that were established during the British rule are also in Bengaluru. Nandi Hills, a summer resort, is 50 kilometers from this city. Heavy public industries like HMT and BHEL are there. Private industries like Infosys, Biocon and others are present. There are four taluks in this district: Bengaluru North, Bengaluru South, Bengaluru East and Anekal. Bruhat Bengaluru Mahanagara Palike oversees the administration of Bengaluru city. Many scenic spots are there in this district. Bannerghatta National Park is a must-see place for children. One can go on a safari here and watch freely roaming wild animals. A snake park is also present here. Famous temples. Many temples like Someshwara Temple of Alsur, Gavi Gangadhareshwara Temple, which belongs to the period of Nada Prabhu Kempegowda's reign, Dodda Basavanna Temple, Dharmaraya Swami Temple and Kote Venkataramana Temple are the most important ones. There are many churches which are more than a century old. St. Andrew's Church, St. Joseph Church are a few to name. Similarly, many masjids that are sacred to Muslims are also there. Sangin Jamia Masjid, Jumma Masjid and Jamia Masjid are important. Khadriya Masjid was built recently in 1981 and Bilal Masjid was built on Bannerghatta Road in 2015. The famous churches of Bengaluru city: St. Mary's Basilica, St. Mark's Cathedral, Infant Jesus Church and St. Francis Xavier Cathedral. Bengaluru Rural District. This district came into existence in 1986. There are four taluks in this district: Nelamangala, Doddaballapura, Devanahalli and Hoskote. Shivagange in Nelamangala Taluk is a famous religious place. Kempegowda International Airport is in Devanahalli. Ramanagara District. This district was formed on 23rd August 2007. There are four taluks: Channapatna, Kanakapura, Ramanagara and Magadi. This district is the fastest growing industrial hub of Karnataka. The Bidadi Industrial Center is one of the prominent industrial centers of the state. There are thousands of medium and small scale industries that are operating here. This district is known for two products: Channapatna wooden toys and silk. Chikkaballapura District. Kolar district was divided to create Chikkaballapura district. It was formed on November 10, 2007. There are six taluks in this district. They are Chikkaballapura, Gauri Bidanuru, Bagepalli, Shidlagatta, Gudibande and Chintamani. Nandidurga is a known hill station. Temples of Yoganandishwara and Boganandishwara are here. Kaivara of Chintamani is a place known for a mystic Tatayya. Vidurashwata is a historical place present in Gauri Bidanuru Taluk. In 1938, Flag Satyagraha was held against the British. A memorial is built here in memory of that event. Nidumamidi Mutt of Bagepalli is well known. Shidlagatta is a known business center. It is famous for its silk business. Kolar District. The moment one hears the word Kolar, the gold mines are remembered. Unfortunately, the gold mines were closed down during 2003. Bangarapete, Kolar, Mulabagilu, Malur and Srinivasapura are the five taluks of Kolar. The main occupations of the people of this district are agriculture, dairying, floriculture and silk production. This district is a dry land often prone to droughts. Chikkatirupati of this district is a well-known religious place. It has many tanks. Antaragange is an important historical place. Places like Hazarat Baba, Haider Ali Dargah and Sri Padarayara Brindavana is in Kolar district. Tumakuru district. Tumakuru district was formed in the year 1832. It is well known for its coconut. It is one of the largest districts of our state. It has 10 taluks. They are Koratagere, Gubbi, Chikkanayakanahalli, Pavagada, Kunigal, Turuvekere, Tiptur, Madhugiri, Shira and Tumakuru. The district has many forts that were built by the Palegaras. The forts are in Madhugiri, Midigeshi, Nidugal, Devarayana Durga, Huliyuru Durga and Sira. The district is known for its educational institutions. Free education and boarding facilities are given to thousands of students at Siddhaganga Math under the leadership of Sri Shivakumara Swamiji. Another important educational institution is Siddhartha Education Society. A unique horse breeding station is present in Kunigal. The district is becoming an important industrial center of the state. Madhugiri has a monolith hill which is the only one in Asia. Devarayana Durga is a famous place. There is a folk song on the tank of Kunigal. The Lakshmi temple of Goravanahalli of Koratagere Taluk is a famous temple. Chitradurga district. Chitradurga is famous for its gigantic seven-ringed fort. Inside the fort, there are ponds and temples. Taluks of Chitradurga are Chitradurga, Hiriyur, Challekere, Hosadurga, Holalkere and Mulakalmuru. This district is known for its Palegaras. Madakari Nayaka was a famous Palegara. Onake Obova is another well-known historical person. S. Nijalingappa, Malladihalli, Raghavendra Swami, Talukina Venkannaya, Tarasu, Sri Shivamurti Murugasharanaru, Taralubalu Swamiji, Kabir Anandashrama's Shivalingananda Swami and Jagalur Imam Saab are the few known personalities. Davanagere district. Davanagere district was formed by dividing Chitradurga in 1997. A few parts of Shivamogga and Harappanahalli of Ballari district were added to the newly formed district of Davanagere. It has 6 taluks: Harihara, Harappanahalli, Channagiri, Honnali, Jagalur and Davanagere. Davanagere was known as the Manchester of Karnataka. During the 1960s, it was famous for its textile production. But due to lack of raw cotton, the mills have been shut down. There are many sugar factories operating. Hundreds of food processing units are working in this district. It has also made name as the important education center of the state. The well-known Bapuji Education Institution is here. The biggest lake in South India, Shanti Sagar, is in Channagiri. It has a circumference of 64 kilometers. The Harihareshwara temple from the Hoysala period is found in Harihara. Shivamogga district. This is one of the famous districts of Karnataka. It is well known for its scenic beauty. There are 6 taluks: Teerthahalli, Sagara, Soraba, Bhadravati, Shivamogga, Shikaripura and Hosanagara. It is called the rice granary of Karnataka. Tungabhadra, Sharavati, Varada and Kumudavati rivers flow in this region. Shankar Ghatta is the home to Kuvempu University. Kuppally, the birthplace of Kuvempu, is in Teerthahalli Taluk. It is now growing as a tourist center. Bhadravati is growing as an industrial hub. The Sharavati Hydroelectric Project and Varahi Hydroelectric Project provide the most of the electricity needs of the state. It is said Shivamogga was founded by Keladi rulers. There is an archaeological museum at Keladi. It is said the name Shivamogga is due to face resembling similarity to Lord Shiva. Jogue Falls, the highest waterfalls in Asia, is in Gerusoppa. There is a bird sanctuary in Gudavi of Soraba Taluk. Bhadra Wildlife Sanctuary is well known. Agumbe of Teerthahalli Taluk receives highest rains. The Tripuranathakeshwara and Kedareshwara temples of Ballighavi are famous. Keladi ruler Shivappa Nayaka had built a beautiful palace in Keladi. Kuvempu and Dr. U.R. Anantamurthy, the recipients of Jnanapitha Award, are from Teerthahalli Taluk of this district. National award-winning singer Shivamogga Subbanna is from this district.